name is Jeff Warren, and at Syracuse High, I teach physics, I teach astronomy, and I also teach a drone class. The entire purpose of this CTE course is to prepare students to take the FAA Part 107 license exam. The FAA Part 107 license gives people the opportunity to fly a drone commercially, and today's lesson was looking at some of the maps and charts that they're going to have to be able to read to be able to fly missions and make flight plans. And so map reading is a big part of the FAA test that they have the opportunity to take after taking this class. When we go out and we set up our flight zone, we check to make sure that the pilot in command knows who their visual observers are. So anytime a drone is in the air, we want to make sure there are no errors in communication so that there's no property damage or any people getting hurt.
In order to be able to fly a drone, you got to know what drone you're flying, first of all. Then you got to get a battery, all of that sort, a landing pad, cones to set up an area where you will be flying. After that, you're going to go through the objectives, turning it on, pairing it to your phone, and once that's done, then there are several maneuvers you can go through. So our visual observers, the people that are looking and calling back, they're letting the pilot know whether they are too close to an obstruction in the way that could possibly damage or harm the drone. The lesson objective is simply control. It is to show that we know how to operate these drones quickly and efficiently. It has been a real treat being able to use these machines and just make some memories flying them around and seeing what it is like from a bird's eye view. Getting my certification, I've got a long way to go. I've still got my badges, but I feel like I'm well on my way to being able to get my certificate.
When they're flying in industry, students are required to have credentials with them at all times. And in our class, we've created credentials to mimic what they would do in industry. We have a rookie, a technician, an administrator, an operator, and a pilot badge. And each one of those corresponds to a learning strand within the course. They help give them a sense of accomplishment and get used to carrying around credentials just like they would need if they were flying for a company or for their own business.
Well, my name is Darren Beardall. I teach high school, 10th, 11th, and 12th grade at Layton High School. Today we're the drone flight class. We're doing some flight maneuver pass-offs here for their technician and rookie badges. These drones themselves have some maneuver capabilities. They can do flips, they can do right flips, left flips, back flips. You can also have the ability to automatically land back where you started. I put them in groups of three today, but you typically have a pilot and a visual observer making sure that he's safe and keeping people safe around where he's going. So that's what we're doing today.
One of my career options I really want to go into is aerospace engineering. And I thought, in order to understand all that type of engineering, is I have to understand how certain objects work. So I took this class because it helps me understand how a drone works. And then I'm in aerospace engineering to learn how to build things that fly. And there's just many career fields with drones.
Most of the time you'll see real estate companies showing a home using a drone. They've got it in dealerships. They've got it in construction management. They're using it for life flight. They're also using it to search and rescue in the mountains where people can't get to. But we're trying to get these kids to the point where they can pass that Part 107 test to go eventually get a job flying drones and do filmography or do real estate or do construction management. That's what I hope. And that's what I want these kids to grow and learn.